Can you name the four internet software layers? Do you know what each layer does? Find out the answers in this video. My name is Tim Pachaka from the Learn Programming Academy, and this is my Learn to Code series here on YouTube. Let's find out more about the four internet software layers and what each layer does, and then dive into internet protocols. There are many, so I will intentionally limit our conversation to just cover the basics. Keep in mind that whole courses could be and are devoted to explaining in detail the internet protocols. Here we go. Any type of message request and response that travels through the internet requires the cooperation of all the computers it passes through. Software controls this transfer process and must reside on each of those internet computers. They are a rigorous set of tasks that must be performed correctly for the process to work. A real-world example is me sending you a real package. I prepare the package with address label, take the package to a shipping company like FedEx or UPS, the shipping company places the package on an airplane, and the airplane flies to its destination. If not the final destination, the package is placed on another airplane and flown to its final destination. The package is then given to your local shipping company, again FedEx or UPS for example. The shipping company delivers the package to you at your address. You open the package and enjoy its contents. In the internet, these coordinator tasks are controlled by layers of software, starting with the application layer software, followed by the transport layer software, the network layer software, and finally the link layer software. The application software prepares your message with destination address. The transport software partitions the message into packets. The network software assigns an intermediate address to each packet, and the link software transfers each packet. How does this work? Well, when you click on a link in your browser, here's what happens. Inside your computer, the application software prepares your message with destination address. The transport software partitions the message into packets. The network software may or may not assign an intermediate address to each packet depending on the destination's address, and the link software transfers each packet. If there is an intermediate address associated with a packet, the link software transfers the packet back to the network software in the intermediate address's computer. That computer's network software assigns either another intermediate address or the final destination address to the packet and then sends it to its link software, and the link software transfers the packet to the next intermediate link layer or final destination link layer software. Assuming the packet has arrived at the destination link layer, the package is passed to that computer's network software, which moves each packet to its transport software, which reassembles all the packets that make up the message, and finally, the transport software passes the message to its application software. Wow, all that just to get the original message to the destination address. Then, the whole process must be reversed as the response is sent from the destination address back to the sender address. And all of this takes place typically in sub-second response time most of the time. That really is amazing. And this is just the process for moving the message from sender to destination and back again, to say nothing about what the destination computer must do to respond to the message before it can send it back. Wow. In 1983, the International Organization for Standardization, IOS, created the Open System Interconnection, OSI, seven-layer model standard consisting of application, presentation, session, transport, network, data link, and physical software layers. Although a standard, it was released after the web's four-layer model, application, transport, network, and link software layers, became the de facto standard, and its adoption is still mostly not used. So what does the internet use to implement the four-layer model? It uses the TCP/IP suite collection of protocol standards. Transmission Control Protocol, TCP, and Internet Protocol, IP, are the two most familiar protocol names in this suite. A third protocol that can be used as a substitute for TCP at the transport software layer is User Datagram Protocol, UDP. For example, in the real world, one might choose FedEx to transport a package, whereas another person may choose UPS. What's the basic difference between TCP and UDP? Well, besides structural differences in how the packaging of a message is done, basically TCP is thought to be more reliable but less efficient than UDP, whereas UDP is thought to be more efficient but less reliable than TCP. The internet's protocol standards have remained fairly consistent over many years now, and there's good reason to think that these standards will evolve and become even more sophisticated and possibly incorporating artificial intelligence and other advanced concepts in the next several years. The internet is alive and thriving today. Virus, worm, Trojan horse, phishing, botnet, spam, and spoofing are just a few of the security issues lurking throughout the internet. Want to know about them more? Check them out in my next video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in that next video. Alrighty, this is the part of the video where I'm meant to get all enthusiastic and to ask you, or quite literally beg you, to subscribe to my channel and to like the video, leave a comment, and all that stuff. Well, I'm going to leave that decision in your capable hands to decide whether I've earned a like or a subscribe or a comment. I'd be grateful if you do one, both, or all three. My videos will get out there and in front of a bigger audience if I get that level of engagement, but obviously it's your choice. Alright, so remember that this series was meant to be watched in order, so if you haven't watched from the start, then how dare you watch my video series out of order? Click the link over here to get to the first video in the series and watch that if you want to see the entire series in order. Or come over here and click to view the previous video in the series, again your choice. Alright, I'm done. Catch you in the next video.